Okay, in this video, we're going to go over quickly how to cut up your model for 3D printing. And we're going to do it inside Plasticity. Slicers do have the option to slice and dice models and key them and everything else, but I'm going to show you how to do it inside a CAD software. And what I did here, so I want to scale him to where he is like 220 millimeters long, okay? So scale, and I'm just going to kind of eyeball it here. All right, 226 is fine, because we're going to cut him up and so he can fit on the print bed easier. He can do it diagonally, but I want to cut it up so it's easier on the printer with the supports and whatnot. So let's, I'm going to open up another file here. And these are available on QBrush and Gumroad for free. My little CAD cutter is here. And basically, they're just sheets with keys built into them. A couple different variety here. I'm going to take this one over here. Copy him. Go back into our project here. Okay. Now, Control V. And they are just a standard 50 millimeter size. You can resize them as needed. Let's see, you're gonna rotate him. Let's see, I want the key to go this way and put the big key up top. Okay. Now let's start lining them up. There for now. Want to do GV. I want to get it lined up perfectly with this edge right here. So we're going to do, we're going to move it on, looks like Z. Yep. Okay. And then hold down control and I can snap it to that edge right there. Perfect. Should be. Let's see how we're lined up here. Okay, so I got a G, V, and that midpoint again. We want to move in the X and then snap it right there. There we go. So now he's perfectly lined up there. Zoom out a bit here so we can see this. I'm going to turn on X-ray. Might help us out. So now we just got to line up the keys there. Let's see. So the keys are going to be pretty big. So I'm going to have to do a little adjustment here. Do scale V. I'm going to keep it lined up there. Okay. So now G, move them up. I want to get that big key kind of in the center there. Okay. Let's see. Not too bad. All right, perfect. So now I could take these edges here. Then I can extend them down. Extend him up. He's already cut through the sides just fine. Okay. So now what we're going to do is we're going to add a little thickness to it. So what I want to do, we're going to do, I've got a hotkey for thickness, so shift T. Then I'm going to turn on snap to grid to 0.1 millimeters, and I want it to go this way. No, this way, towards the handle. So this way it'll be nice and flush with that face there. We're going to do just 0.1, so this way that cuts nice and close. Now, I'm going to select them again. Isolate and turn off X-ray. And do, just want to select all of these faces in here. And we still have grid on. I'm just going to give it just a little more. Another 0.3 millimeters. Okay, so it gives us a little more clearance or that key to go in there. But the main slice is still only 0.1. So this way it'll be nice and flush to each other whenever we glue it together. So we come out. Let me do Alt Z again. See how those keys look inside there. Okay, perfect. So now obviously we pick our gun, pick our cutter, and then Q. Right click to execute. Let's take a look at our isolate the gun or the handle off X-ray. Nice. Perfectly keyed up. All right, so let's see how this works inside. Let's turn off that sheet there and let's go ahead and export. And STL file is fine. That's what we want. Yes, replace. Going to be a pretty dense gun. That's fine. The higher the poly, the better. Prusa only likes about a million polygons, or it really starts to bog down. So let's get rid of the old gun here. Let's bring up the new gun. All right, let's see. Yep, you can see your cut right in there. Perfect. So now all I have to do is just split into objects. And you get some of these oddities every once in a while. It's usually a floating island inside your mesh if you boolean things together, which is fine. Just hold down Shift or deselect. Hold down Shift and delete. There we go. Now we can just hit F, place it. There we go. Now I'm gonna do with the gun, I'm gonna do F right there. There we go. Perfectly, yep. Looks like it worked out pretty good. So now we can just space everybody around here. He's going to need quite a bit of support around him. Put these little guys over here. And I'm going to keep him upright like that. This way it's easier to clean off the support off of this one surface than trying to clean it off. Yeah, it's just ugly wherever else I do it, so it's just, we'll just do it that way. And let's go ahead and slice and see what happens. Let's take it all the way down to the bottom and see how he did way down here. Oh, perfect. Yep, it looks like it's going to be a pretty successful print, I believe. Obviously, do a little more tweaking here and there on the model, make it work better. But that's basically 3D print cutters or CAD cutters. Very handy little thing there, so definitely go pick them up, and we'll catch you in the next video.